everybody, and welcome to my YouTube channel Rituparna Creates. I am Rituparna Roy. If this is the first time that you're watching my videos, first of all, thank you. Second of all, welcome. Do check out my other videos as well. I create videos on stationery, books, hauls, vlogs, poetry, and so many other fun stuff, and I upload new videos every week. If you're enjoying my content, please do consider subscribing, give a big thumbs up to this video, and let's begin. So here we are, another week, another Tuesday, slowly coming towards the end of this year, and I just wanted to go through with you what I have read in this year. Now, I had recently uploaded a video on my favorites of 2021. I'll link this video here. You can go check that out. It is all about other things apart from books, because I thought it would be only apt if I make a separate video just for my books and what all things I read this year. So first, talking about what was the plan or like the goal for reading this year. So it was very simple. It was like 12 months and 2 books every month. So around 24 books if possible, or a minimum of 20. So yeah, I have been able to achieve that. I have read 22 and I am currently reading the 23rd book as well. I will insert the picture here. I have not completed it. That's why I have not included it here in this video. But yeah, I think before the year ends, I will be able to finish it. It's a very light read. It's a very casual read and I'm just taking my time with it. So when I say that, okay, every month I wanted to read 2 books, the idea was that I wanted to increase my reading of non-fiction books. That could be anything related to productivity, self-help, habits, or you know, any book related to business which can help me in my job, what I do, or anything related to even writing, so that it can help me understand writing and poetry and all of that better. So the non-fiction for me was all of that, and fiction is of course all of the books that I usually read. So I have divided the books here according to the fiction and the non-fiction. I was not able to read a lot of non-fiction, but yeah, we have some and these were good picks. So let's start with the fiction pile. I feel that is my favorite. And these are not really reviews. I'll just very quickly walk you through. Otherwise, God knows how long this video will be. Some of these authors were new. I tried mixing it up and, you know, trying different genres in fiction as well. And some of them were misses and some of them were, of course, I really loved them. And I look forward to reading more of their books for the next year. And yeah, let's begin. Please don't judge my jugaad here. So beginning with the fiction pile, I do love a good thriller and a mystery, and this year I have come upon 2 writers whose books I have really loved, absolutely loved. The first one is Anthony Horowitz. These are the 2 books that I read of his this year. These are Magpie Murders and this is Moonflower Murders. They are connected in a way. I saw this recommended book recommendations on Joita's Instagram. Joita is an artist who I follow. So yeah, she recommended this on her Instagram and I was like instantly sold. I was like, I have to get this. I have read Anthony Horowitz a book many ages ago called The Word is Murder. But these were really nice. If you are looking something in the mystery thriller genre, would highly recommend this. Coming to the next author, and I have spoken about this so much, is Richard Osman and the 2 of his books, Thursday Murder Club Part 1 and Part 2. So yeah, I have really enjoyed this. I really like his writing and I'm going to buy the 3rd part, which is coming out next year as well. These books were murder mystery thriller, very well written, very it keeps you like guessing until the last you know, page, like what is going to happen. A sure thriller and page turner. Coming to some different types of genres of books that I tried this year, So this was a very interesting book that I picked up, The Authenticity Project by Claire Pooley. I think I saw this on Instagram on somebody's post, somebody's stories, and I picked it up from Amazon. So yeah, very interesting concept. I really liked it. A very warm and kind of a heartfelt, a very soulful book. Really well written. Again, would recommend if you're looking for something nice and, you know, like very warm on a cold winter day, go ahead and check this out. Next is this book by Neil Gaiman, The Graveyard Book, a children's fantasy book, I would say. I really liked it. It's about a boy who is raised in a graveyard. Dark also, but at the same time, very, very enjoyable. If you have not read any of Neil Gaiman's work before, do check him out. He has a lot of books, and I want to read another one of his books in the coming year as well. And yeah, highly, highly recommend. Do check it out. This was an illustrated version that I got. So there was some illustrations in between the pages as well. And I really, really liked it. Really nice, very enjoyable. Talks about ghosts and witches and so many things. Yeah, really, really enjoyed. Coming to a Japanese book, you might have seen this in one of my videos, one of the monthly reads. This is Before the Coffee Gets Cold, another very interesting book. Tells us a lot about how the culture and the city and a little bit about their food and all. Very interesting. It's about time travel, but in a different take of on time travel. Yeah, really, really enjoyed this one as well. Another Japanese book was this, The Traveling Cat Chronicles by Hiro Arikawa. First of all, I'll tell you this. Look at this book. Very heartfelt, very warm book. Leaves you a little heartbroken at the end. It's that kind of a book, you know, really touches your soul. Very interesting. It's about a road trip and then between a cat and his owner. And yeah, really, really liked it. Would highly recommend. Then I read this, A Man Called Ove by Frederick Backman, which again, I would say that I highly recommend. You must be thinking all the books are nice, but usually I do a lot of research before I buy a book because, you know, I sometimes, as I said, books are misses also. Sometimes you get something and then you don't like it. But then I try to do my due diligence. Really heartfelt book. It will make you laugh. It will make you cry. It will make you happy. It will make you sad. It will make you all of that. If you are looking for something to read, start your new year with this book. I would say that. I reread Tuesdays with Maury by Mitch Albom. It is one of my all-time favorite books. And life's lessons, it's a little philosophical, and it's not preachy, you know, it's just philosophical. It's not really preachy. It's not like telling you like, oh, do this, do that, but yeah, really, really enjoyed. Coming to the next, this is The Number One Ladies Detective Agency by Alexander McCall Smith. It's a different book. It's based out, the story is based in Botswana. There are many books in this one. I'll try reading some of his other books as well. It's nice, it's something different. Gives you a little bit of insight into how the Botswana culture and people are. And really nice. It's a little humorous, and it talks about people and their failings. I liked it. It's a nice read. Then we come to another book which I saw a lot on social media. This is Where the Crawdads Sing by Delia Owens, and really liked it. What I really liked was that it is, of course, the story and all. It's nice. But it also talks so much about nature. It talks about principles and kind of human emotions and all of that. Very, very well written. Fine. Coming to the, I think this is the last for the fiction one. We have The Midnight Library by Matt Haig. I did not enjoy this book as much as I thought I would. This is again a kind of a time travel science fiction-y kind of a book. Would have been better, I feel. Right, and now let us talk about all the non-fiction books that I read. So in the two non-fiction books I would like to start with is this and this. I'll insert images here. One is Influence, one is Hyperfocus. I read them in the ebook format. and I don't have the physical copy with me. These both were part of Hustle Post Academy's book club that we do, and I really enjoyed Hyper Focus. I think I would reread it again in the month of January, the points that I had highlighted, because I think with all this technology, with managing, you know, an Instagram account, a YouTube, work, and it has just really led to our attention span becoming smaller and smaller and smaller. Patience, I was always not a very patient person, and I think that patience has even reduced with all this, all the things that we are surrounded with constantly. And I feel it is something that everyone should read, Hyper Focus, this book. I was really, really highly recommend. Influence, on the other hand, was more focused on the psychology of people and how marketeers and salespeople use that human psychology to sell us things and to get us into buy their products. If you are into the marketing and sales part or department, then you can definitely check this book out. It's a little outdated because it was written, I think, a long time back, but I think a revised edition is available. The one that I downloaded, I think, was the older version. But yeah, anyways, you should check it out. Some really, really good tips and tricks on how we can better our, you know, as a salesperson or as a marketing person, how we can better our selling skills and how do we utilize the human psychology. Right. Next, coming to the two most smallest books that I read in nonfiction. This is Eat That Frog, Brian Tracy's 21 Great Ways to Stop Procrastinating. Again, this is something I feel, you know, with nonfiction, it's not like a novel, right? Once you like read and you are done and finished, okay, ho gaya, you keep it in your book. I think it is something that you read, you understand, you implement, you highlight. So this is going to be another one of the books that I am going to read through again. 21 very, very doable, easy, practical tips on how one can stop procrastinating and how to go forward with it. Would highly recommend. It's a very small book, can be read by anybody. Start the year with something like this, you know, give yourself that push and that motivation. Right. The next book that I read was How to Be a Writer by Ruskin Bond. So this book was essentially meant for young writers, young adults. I'm an adult. I'm not so sure about the young part, but yeah, I think it's became a little too simple for me. It is his advice. It cannot be bad. But yeah, if you are a bit younger, just starting off to write, this book will really, really help you. The another book that I read on writing this year was Bird by Bird by Anne Lamott. And I have spoken about this book so much, you can see through all of this, that I am in absolute love with this book, right? I recommend this book to everybody. If you are a writer, if you're starting off, you have written for a very long time, go ahead and read this book. This book will help you understand everything. Right from publishing to the writing nitty-gritties, the thing that we go through, discipline, motivation, all of that is covered so greatly in this book. Highly, highly recommend, one of my favorite reads of this year. Another one of my favorite reads of this year is this book by Elizabeth Gilbert, Big Magic. So these two books are going to be always there with me. I have absolutely fallen in love with this book. So, so well written. Again, for anybody out there, if you are a writer, an artist, a dancer, a photographer, anybody, pick up this book and read it. It is so, so well written, talks and breaks down about the creativity and the process so, so well. I am sure you would love it. I read a book on productivity, which was highly, highly, I had seen on social media and I had seen people talk about it a lot. That is Atomic Habits. Right. Again, I think this is one of those books that you will have to, you know, read, understand and implement. It has such good instructions. It is so instructive, so educational and informative in nature. So yeah, do check it out. The last book in the nonfiction pile that we are going to talk about is Deep Work. Deep Work really challenged me because it was a little difficult to understand and a little difficult to how do we say, process it and absorb it. It's a little challenging book. The advice and everything is good. I understood, like, it's not that it's not, that you won't be able to understand it, but it's a little challenging to read. Anyways, that is what I felt. But yeah, a little advanced, I think, because, and that is one thing, is that because probably I don't read a lot of nonfiction or these kinds of books. So, you know, I feel with reading also we mature, right? So the more and more you read, the more and more mature you become with your choice of books, genres of books, you open up to the idea of different types of books. So yeah, I think I'll reread it again in some time, and I think I'll be able to process it much better. And with that, we come to an end of all the 22 books that I have read this year. And I hope you enjoyed this video. We'll see how next year goes. Did you enjoy this video? Have you read any of these books? Or you can tell me what books you have read this year and what have you enjoyed. Any specific book that surprised you or that you did not like, drop them down in the comment and we will have a good chat about it. Do recommend me some books for next year as well, now that you know what kind of stuff that I usually read. And I'm always, always open and up for book recommendations. Thank you for watching. Give a big thumbs up if you enjoyed, and I'll see you again in the next video. Till then, stay safe, stay happy and healthy. Bye.